start with, we first part of December, we'll make our order for the coming year. So I've already put my order in for my 2020 crop. The first potatoes will get here about the 20th of March. We'll plant two greenhouses the 20th of March, and then we'll harvest them the end of June. Then the two big greenhouses, we'll raise two crops. The 11 greenhouses that are up there on the corner, we only just do one crop there. We'll plant those the 1st of June, and we'll harvest around 30,000 pounds of pre-nuclear, the mini tuber potatoes that come from the plants.
I took care of determining where we're going to put the varieties, and I took care of the mapping because we keep track of what potatoes we planted where, how much greenhouse space they take up. And then we take that information and use it to determine how much yield that we get on the potatoes. Mm-hmm. And then that helps us decide what's the best soil medium to use in the greenhouse.
Process takes a lot of time, and when we cut those, we disinfect the knives between every potato. We'll cut a potato, switch knives, and we have the potatoes in a little disinfecting glass. Mm-hmm. And we got enough knives that they can our staff can rotate through the knives, and we can disinfect them, and that helps with, you know, to mitigate spread of disease. Came here in 1994 to start raising seed in Samurai Valley. We had 240 acres the first year, and from there, you know, over time we moved up to about 560, and we backed off. That was just too much for what we're doing. And that's another thing about raising foundation seed is you can't get very big because it's a pretty hands-on process. And if you get over, you know, if you get much over 450, 500 acres, you're not a foundation seed grower anymore because you need to be there all the time. Somebody that's pretty passionate, keep your variety separated, and it's a pretty challenging process.